At that time, there were no efficient lasers in the sense of efficiency, in the sense that if you put 100 watt of electrical energy in, you get, let's say, at least 10 watts of optical energy out. No such thing existed. The lasers in the visible part of the spectrum were extremely inefficient, I mean something like 0.1% or less than that. However, there were some very efficient lasers in infrared. And we felt a little bit unsure about what the prognosis was. We thought that if somebody, we didn't do any development of lasers, that was too far from our daily routine. We thought that if someone came up with a really efficient laser in red, blue, and green, all hell would break loose. I mean, we would have people parking on our doorstep saying, now that we've got these lasers, how do we make a projected TV picture of it? So we felt we ought to be prepared for this. It never happened. It never happened. It is true that you can now get solid-state lasers that are fairly efficient, certainly compared to what we had many years ago. And a number of firms have tried to continue on the along the road that our group pointed in the article that I gave you. But no one has ever been commercially successful. Apparently, it's just not in the cards. Now, of course, this could, something could happen tomorrow that turns that around, but it hasn't.